moment drafting my personal checklist. So I will be making that announcement once I'm ready. Then maybe then you all can, you know, see whether I am ticking the boxes as I go along. I want to be seen as someone who have actually delivered and make sure that MACC is an agency which is respected and it is feared by anyone who thinks that they can get away with corruption, and at the same time that I could get a tangible result, which means I would be able to show the amount that we have saved, the number of cases that we have reduced. I know 2 years is not long, but I think it's achievable if that's all my focus is. Far more advanced than what you've probably heard 10 years ago. So in that context, I think a lot of the officers when I meet, when they bring me to see the lockups, the interrogation, they always, without fail, mention that the start of fixing things, putting things properly in order to avoid any more mishaps is Teo Beng Hock and also Sarbaini. But in a way, that marked for them to actually do better. In fact, they are quite amazing. My job is, if there is corruption, I will deal with it. Let's come back to the general point, that is that anyone who has done wrong in terms of corruption, I will investigate. Give me the evidence, then we will deal with it. Whether I'm independent or not, it is actually for the public to judge me on how I'm going to take on cases, which then only the perception will come in. So it's a bit strange for me to say, you know, it's not for me to say that I'm independent and I'm fair in this. I think the public needs to make that call and make the decision. So they have to judge me.